Okay. You froze for a minute. Can you hear me? Oh, you're frozen. Oh, Chris froze. Maybe he's possessed. Are you possessed, Chris? Hello? Chris? Is your spirit possessed? I'm taking a picture of this. Welcome to Crosscut, a movie review slash trivia challenge show, and I'm your co-host, Josh.
And I'm your other co-host, Chris.
So today we are taking a look at Haunted Mansion, about a single mom named Gabbie who hires a tour guide, a psychic, and a priest, and a historian to help exorcise her newly bought mansion after discovering it is inhabited by ghosts. Now, before we get into the movie, we do want to issue a spoiler warning, as this episode is going to contain spoilers, so if you've not seen Haunted Mansion yet, we do highly recommend pausing this episode. Go get yourself a nice big old popcorn and that tasty beverage. Put whatever you want in there. Could be pop, could be vodka, could be whatever you want. You may need it for this movie. For everybody else, let's begin. All right, Chris. So I picked this week's movie and I'm already regretting it.
No.
So, real fast. You already know this. I went and saw a different, I saw Haunted Mansion today. I saw a different movie last night called Talk to Me, an A24
right.
horror movie. Fantastic. Highly recommend that movie. That's the one we should be talking about now. Instead, we're going to be talking about another Disney piece of crap that's coming out this summer.
Ooh.
Haunted Mansion. Okay, so this is my metaphor I'm going to use today. You have one of those things where you put like the marbles in and it goes up and down because of the weight, right?
Yeah. So
this is how I felt during the movie. I start here, and immediately I'm going this way, as in the movie's bad. I'm just like, ooh, I'm just like, things aren't working. And then you know what? Something happens and it goes back up a bit. And maybe it goes back up a bit. And then it goes this way again. And then everything falls off of it. And the marbles are all over the place.
Oh.
So this movie had moments. I will say this movie had its moments. I thought there were some like decent times where it did make me chuckle at times. I did say in the other episode that it's not funny, but I did giggle a couple times, especially Tiffany Haddish. I thought she was the best part of this movie. I thought, you know, they try to do these emotional beats, they don't really work. I think she did the best one. She's talking about her dad, things like that. One of my notes is that, so the movie opens with Lakeith Stanfield, he's our main character Ben, he's meeting his pretty much future wife, and I'm already like, cut that scene out, that doesn't need to be in the movie. The movie should have opened with Rosario Dawson and her son going straight to the Haunted Mansion. The movie's called Haunted Mansion. Just opening scenes should be with the Haunted Mansion. Because honestly, the Lakeith Stanfield character, just I cared less about him. It's just one of those, I don't know, it just felt one of those like insert emotional thing here when they were writing the movie for him.
I'll give you this. I do like the idea that they should have done the mothering kid at first, like opening scene instead of him. I know that it should have been focused on them and not him. Cause,
yeah, like if he showed up when they're already going through stuff, you could have learned more about his backstory at that point. You know,
right? Like it should have been reversed.
Yeah, pretty much. Instead, you're just getting like nonsense scenes of him already. Mm-hmm. Just like he starts off this way, and then he's already depressed because his wife died, which was already like happened really quick. And I just feel like they could have cut all that out and they could have just started with him going to the mansion for the first time as if he got hired from Owen Wilson. Mm-hmm. And he could have just explained like, hey, I'm here to do this thing. He's already a skeptic. And then you could have learned his backstory that way. And I feel like it would have been much better because this is a 2-hour movie. This movie's pretty long. And I can tell that scenes were already cut because there's certain actors in this movie who had like barely any scenes. First example, he does the tour guide in the beginning. One of the guys, he's an actor I know, his name's Steve Zisis. He plays in a lot of Duplass Brothers movies. He's in like all the Duplass Brothers movies. And I'm like, oh, that's Steve Zisis. And he has no line. So I'm like, okay, so clearly he got cut out of something. And then later on, they go to the Crump Manor and Dan Levi from Schitt's Creek, shows up. He's in the opening credits and everything. And he's got like one quick scene. And he's out.
Right.
Best part of that whole scene, by the way, is Winona Ryder showing up, who's not even in the credits. She has more screen time than Dan Levi, but she doesn't even get credit.
I didn't even know she was in the movie.
You didn't realize that was her?
I noticed it was her when she comes on in the scene, but I didn't know she was in the movie, period.
Oh, right. I feel like they were kind of keeping that one, you know. That was like a nice little like moment, you know, where it's like, it's Winona Ryder. And that scene is funny. That actually was like a pretty funny scene. So that was maybe the one funny scene in the whole movie.
I did like that part, you know, that they brought in cameos like that. But I did expect more from Danny DeVito and Owen Wilson. Owen Wilson was playing himself, yes, but it could have gotten a little bit more.
Even his reveal was just like, that he's basically a fraud. He's not actually a priest. Right. I'm just like, I don't care. Like, maybe they should have like revealed that earlier, and then he could have had this like moral dilemma throughout the movie of like.
Or they could have just left him as the priest,
Sure, yeah. Because at that point, I'm just like, is this supposed to be his like character arc at this point? Like, are we supposed to feel for him? And I'm just like, I just don't care at this point.
I didn't feel like this was more typical Donnie DeVito either. Maybe it's because he was more like a, not even a secondary character, more like a fourth character out of the whole thing, because he was just there for a little bit.
Yeah.
You know, but I enjoyed more of the lore. That's what I was more interested in.
And that's like, why I don't know if this will ever work as a movie. I mean, I still think that Disney failed on another Haunted Mansion movie. I think my idea for what they should do with Haunted Mansion, and they probably screwed up anyways, but make it an anthology series, almost like a Twilight Zone. Every episode could be a different story of a different ghost that got there, kind of thing. I think that would be interesting, because you could really play into lore. You could make it half hour episodes. Yeah. Do like a Haunted Mansion anthology show. Of course, it'd end up on Disney Plus, and it would probably look like crap, but that's my idea. You know, I always thought that would be like an interesting thing.
Could be a good idea, though, because there is a lot of ghosts.
Well, that's the whole idea. It's 999 ghosts. You know, I mean, almost each one could be its own thing. And when you go through the ride and you see it in the movie, every scene is almost like a different story. So you have the Hatbox ghost. You have the bride who's in the movie, Constance Hathaway. You have that ballroom scene where everyone's dancing, the two guys shooting each other, which again, like this movie, I will give them this. They do a good job of like actually incorporating that stuff in throughout the movie. Like I know the Eddie Murphy movie never really had any of that stuff. I know they had certain things like the hitchhiking ghosts, but like they really like, as far as like the detailed stuff, like even this one, there's a quick scene of the cat lady, the picture of the cat lady, you know what I'm talking about? When you're walking into the ride. They have all the pictures, and then when the lightning.
Oh yeah.
Something else. So they even had a quick one of her, which I got. That was like a nice little touch. But yeah, just like everything could be its own little story. So I just I don't know if it works in a movie sense.
I enjoyed it more because it was just the Haunted Mansion, the story of the Haunted Mansion ish. But yes, there were some giggles here and there. I didn't laugh a lot. I did giggle like you did. I do agree with you on that. They could have done a little bit more with the comedians, but they didn't utilize the comedians that were there.
Yeah, I mean, they have some really funny people. Even like Jamie Lee Curtis, like she had some like little funny moments. I love the one part where she's like, she's all serious and she's saying like, I don't even know how long I've been in here, probably months. And they all just kind of like quiet looking around. So. Really? I mean, like, there's funny stuff like that, but it's not like, I don't know. I even feel like a Pirates of the Caribbean movie makes you laugh harder, and it's not. And those movies are taken more seriously. And one of the things that I knew already that this movie was going to do, it was going to be very heavy visual effects. Probably the scene that stood out the most that I just was like, oh, this could have looked so good on a huge soundstage with just like actual set design would have been the graveyard. Or the cemetery, the backyard.
Whoa, that would have been a good one.
But you can just tell that they're on like some virtual stage with some like LED backdrop or something. That's
The only thing practical is the headstones.
Pretty much.
Yeah. I know. I did notice that it was, and like the only thing practical, the headstone and the fog, but that's it. But if they could have used the. I was going to say they could have used some of the technology that they use in the ride. That would have been cool.
When it comes down to it, the Haunted Mansion is just it's a dark ride. You go in and things kind of jump out at you, and there's a lot of like animatronics, and they do obviously some really cool like little visual effects, but you know, ultimately it's a dark ride, and that's what the movie should feel like, and it's not. And honestly, one of the things that really like I noticed heavily in the beginning was like the lighting in this movie is just so weird. Like there's scenes where it's just like so dark, I'm just like, I can't even see, like it's like bare, it's, I think it's supposed to be like moonlight kind of on them, and I'm just like, like turn some lights on in the house, like I can't even see what's like going on in there.
Well, and that's another thing, the practical lights from the like the candelabras and everything weren't that light.
Like that picture that you have in your background, that like that to me looks good.
Yes,
but it's not like that for most of the movie. Like it should be that, like those flames and like kind of like when in Harry Potter when they're in the dining hall, like how it just has the orange glow. Like it should make you feel like it's Halloween, you know. Like make it that, you know, make this, if you're gonna go colorful, make it colorful. But there's just so many scenes where I'm just like, it just looks like I'm just like squinting. I'm like, what the hell am I looking at?
I was a bit like a half on the seance room. Because I like how they turned on the lights, you know, the whole like National Treasure kind of thing with the oil. Also, same thing with the lighting; it was off.
Yeah,
like it wasn't too warm, and it, like the like my background either, because it was a mix. I still go back to the same thing. Everything that they brought from the ride, I loved. You know, and a certain people from the audience too, around me were like pointing out like, oh yeah, like oh, I remember that, and like oh, clearly yeah, they're paying attention to the ride details,
which and at most times is background fodder and not the forefront characters, which is the unfortunate part.
Yes.
So yeah, that's Haunted Mansion. Do you want to take a look at IMDb and Rotten Tomatoes? Don't go too generous this week.
For the Haunted Mansion, I'm going to go with a 5.7.
All right. It's actually a 6.1 at the moment. So it's a little higher. Might go down. We'll see. 6.1 on IMDb. It's got a 49 Metascore. It's pretty bad.
Ooh.
41 tomato meter. It's pretty bad. 83% audience score, but they're just being generous.
It's because of the lore.
Yeah. Just go on the ride. Well, that's my whole
people
thing.
People are going to Haunted Mansion because of the ride.
And this movie's not even going to do that well at the box office. I think it's predicting like 30 million. So Oppenheimer and Barbie are still going to be at top. Yeah, this movie. The Disney struggles will be continuing this summer. Pop quiz, Hotshot. Two guys watch a movie. Who remembers the most about it? Well, let's find out. This is how it works. Chris and I are going to go back and forth asking the multiple choice questions that we each came up with. Whoever has the most points at the end. Well, you know, they win.
Which is me this time.
We'll see. Chris could even beat his fiance, who's never been on the show before last week. So, he's technically on six, seven game losing streak. He needs one. He's desperate. For our audience members, feel free to play along. Who knows? You may do better than us. Comment and let us know how you did. But now that we've established the rules, let's play. I did technically pick this week's movie, and I'm going to ask the first question. What, Chris? I'm going to give you an easy one.
Oh, okay.
Start you off nice and easy. Before I pull the rug out under your feet. Round one, question one. Here we go. What city does this take place in? Is it A, Baton Rouge, B, New Orleans, C, Shreveport, or D, Lafayette?
New Orleans.
I already gave you the point. All right. Point for Chris.
All right. In the beginning, they show a cemetery, right? As part of like the going through the whole town, whatever. What was the name of the cemetery? Was it A, New Orleans Cemetery, B, Fernet Cemetery, C, Steinhurst Cemetery, D, Crump Cemetery?
Fournette Cemetery.
Correct.
I specifically made a note to think of the running back Leonard Fournette, football player.
Nice.
All right. 1-1 after one round. Okay. Round two. Here we go. How much money does Father Kent tell Ben he'll get paid to take the pictures? Was it A, $1,000, B, $2,000, C, $3,000, or D, $4,000?
$2,000.
$2,000 is correct.
All right. Question for you. What did William Gracie's wife die from? Was it A, Spanish flu, B, childbirth, C, yellow fever, D?
Ooh. Is it yellow fever?
Correct.
Okay. I remember there was a fever, but I was like, you said flu, and I was like, wait. But yeah.
I threw you off for that.
A little bit. But I think I remember the yellow in there, so.
Yeah.
All right. After two rounds, we're currently tied 3-3. Moving on to round three. Here we go. What scent of candle does Gabbie light during the seance? Was it A, sandalwood, B, jasmine, C, fresh linen, or D, vanilla?
Vanilla.
Vanilla is correct, just like Chris's dance moves at a wedding.
Oh, what is with the roast?
Just going for it today.
Okay.
If you want to win, you better come to play.
Oh, okay. Question for you. The bride ghost killed how many husbands? Was it A, 3, B, 4, C, 5, D, 6?
I believe it was 5.
Correct.
I was torn between 4 and 5, but I thought I remember hearing the word 5. I do remember seeing them in the pictures, but I think they also say 5 at one point. I could be wrong.
They do.
Okay.
No, they do say 5.
Question 4. According to Madame Leota, specifically from Madame Leota, how many souls does the Hatbox Ghost have at the mansion? Was it A, 933, B, 935, C, 936, or D, 939? Now, if you really think about it, if you can remember that scene, they throw another number out, and if you can do easy math, then you can figure it out. But I know math's not your strong point, so that's why I'm asking it.
939?
I'm sorry.
That is incorrect. The correct answer is 933. Danny DeVito tells them that they have 66 ghosts. 933 plus 66 is 999 happy haunts. One more makes 1,000.
All right. So question for you. Part of this one. Which poison did William Gracie take? Is it A, arsenic, B, cyanide, C, acetone, D, graphite?
The answer is arsenic.
Correct.
Correct.
After four rounds, Josh is currently winning 10-6, which means Chris needs to get this answer correct or else he loses. Now here's the good question. Here's the good news for Chris. My toughest remaining question is the one that he just asked, which means I gotta change things up a bit. So, what board game is Travis holding when Ben is setting up cameras? Was it A, Battleship, B, Chess, C, Monopoly, or D, Clue?
Monopoly.
Correct.
Chris is currently winning, going to the final question, which means I get this right, I win, and I win the season. I get this wrong, I lose. Chris hangs on for the season.
I'm going to go with this one.
Okay.
What kind of ghost follows Father Kent? Was it A, a sailor, B, a man on a horse, C, a woman with half her face, D, a mummy?
I'm going to go with a woman with half her face.
Correct, Mundo.
Correct.
Woo! Five.
Did you really have to think about that one?
I was thinking mummy, but I was like, well, he sees the mummy at the end. He's the one he tells the mummy to turn around. So I was like, I don't think a mummy was following him. But I remember him having that dialogue about having half of her face, and he had some little funny line about it. So,
yeah. I tried to trick you with like, okay, Ben had the sailor, the medium had the man on a horse. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Yep. Okay.
All right. So Josh wins this game of Pop Quiz Hotshot. Josh also wins this season of Pop Quiz Hotshot. This is Josh's third season that he's won, and guess how many seasons we've played? Three.
I mean, I've come close.
Come close, but no cigar. So next week, I'll have to figure out a new movie for Chris to put on his name tag. Maybe I'll just tell him to put Haunted Mansion because it's awful.
Oh!
But which Haunted Mansion? I guess the Eddie Murphy one, I think, is technically called The Haunted Mansion, because this one's just Haunted Mansion. That's how you differentiate in 2023. It's not, you know.
It's just the or no the.
Exactly. So, I don't know. I'll figure a good one out for you for next week. So, stay tuned. Stay tuned. And if you want to support the show, you can do so by hitting that like button for this episode. You can also subscribe to the channel. Stay up to date for future episodes.
Thank you, everyone, for watching and or listening. Cut, print, moving on. Woo!